Hey June, it's me. I would like to show you this wrap what I did from the flaxseed. Here's some dill and this kind of mayo. Just wanted to show you, but I like this. I want you to show also my garden a little bit better. I planted today some more tomatoes, and I counted all tomatoes. I have altogether 96 tomato plants. I think I'm gonna dehydrate a lot and put with oil and garlic and some basil for the winter.
This is the goji chapati after about 24 hours. See that? And this is the dal. It's actually green peas. And you know, in India, they normally just dip that there. It's yum. Pretty cool. I was trying to invite my mom, friend, because then he's Indian and he can taste the chapati. But he's too busy in his temple, so. So I'll tell you what's in the chapati. It's 1/2 cup chia seeds, 1 1/4 cup water, 1/2 cup goji berries. You soak these three together. I mean, the chia seeds and goji in water. And then, when you're ready to process it, you put 1/2 teaspoon black salt, 1 teaspoon salt. 1 teaspoon salt might be salty for you, so you have to adjust it according to taste. 1/2 teaspoon fenugreek, ground fenugreek. 1/2 teaspoon mustard powder. 1/2 cup flax seeds. 2 tablespoon nutritional flakes. 2 tablespoon lucuma powder. This is the sweetener powder. Remember lucuma, L-U-C-U-M-A. Pinch hing or asafoetida. 1/2 cup cashews. And then you puree it. I sent you the video, right? And this is the finished chapati. Really good. It's kind of like... So for the dal, it's 1 cup cold frozen peas, 1/2 cup water, 1/4 cup olive oil, 1 teaspoon mango powder or amchur powder. You can find it in the Indian shop. 1/2 teaspoon turmeric or curcuma, as you said. 1/2 teaspoon salt. 4 days. Pinch cayenne. Or more cayenne if you like it. And then pinch garam masala. 1 inch ginger chop. Process everything in a food processor. Dehydrate for maybe 5 minutes to sort of warm it up. And then serve it warm with chapatis.